previously on Dragons Fire.
Every game we play is a final now, three finals, and we're the league champions.
Mustache's last game, man.
The Mustache's looking good, man. It's the last game for the Mustache.
The Dragons going to have to play smart defensively tonight, I think. And it's another goal! Proof that the Nottingham Lions' plan of attack is sound.
But the worst of all, Bryn, is what we talk about every game. Stupid penalties.
But one man ran that whole show tonight, and that was Palak. And, you know, there's no doubt that is a top player. He earns his money, and he's doing his job. My guys are still paying £90 a month to play, and we're enjoying our hockey.
Development League's fine, and if you want that mentality, you're not a winner. You're developing kids in your development league. Leave them there. We're developing players so they can play at a higher standard. We're not developing players so they can stay at the same standard.
The reason I was annoyed with the referees is because that's the top of the league table, top of the table clash. I mean, you're looking at a team that's probably going to finish third and a team that's probably going to win the league. And we've got a young lad, an inexperienced referee, and we've got a referee who should be a pensioner now, who retired, I believe, at the end of last season and had decided to come back. So for a game like that, the IAT should have probably thought about getting the best refs here, and certainly having three for a game like that. And I think if we'd have had three referees, they would have stamped their authority on the game, and it wouldn't have gone into that situation of, you know. And also, I was disappointed with Nottingham sending out players to like to start fighting. They lost the game, and he sent out fellas to start fighting. And I know what it was for. It wasn't to vent their anger on the night. It was purely to try and get us kicked out for the following game, for the whole game. And possibly the witness game. And I think Hull might do the same. I'm hoping they won't, because I know Andy quite well. And I hope they won't, but it's a possibility that if they're losing the game, they can think they're playing witness tomorrow. Let's see what we can do to get a few of the Palacha super kicked out the game. So we don't want it to get to that. I wouldn't do that. I mean, you want to go to places and win games. You don't want to be remembered for causing murder. And that's not going to do his development team any good, is it? He goes on about development all the time, Matt Bradbury. He goes on about development all the time, and he's sending lads in cages to fight grown men. And the grown man's not going to fight a lad in a cage. And then some of them lads in cages shouldn't have cages on anyway, because they're all in their 20s. So it's all that. Like I said, Saturday, if you've got the mindset that your team's in a development league and you're developing players, stay in the development league. We haven't got that here. We're the first team here, and we want to get out of this league. And we want to, you know, we've got a 5-year plan where we want to be, you know, looking to get out of the first division, maybe even get into EPL. So the development league side of it, yeah, we've set a team up this year to get out the development league and win the league. We've got a great skating side, a lot of good players. Conor Glossop's a fantastic player, but what does Conor Glossop do? Development team, plays for TV under 20s. Wants to come and play for me next season. He's welcome, the first division. But is he a development player? No, he's not. He's too good for that team. If you develop, he goes on, oh, this was such a body's first game, this was Sutty's second. He's got a GB international playing for him, an under 20 under national. And by the way, I don't know how old he is. He's obviously under 20, but he could be 19. He could be early 20s. He's a man. He's a grown man who plays for Great Britain. And he's a really good hockey player. So, all this development league stuff. And you ask anyone in our league, you want to get out, you want a better team and you want to get out of this league, they'd say yeah to you. And we've got an under-20s league, that should be a development league. And we've got an under-20s league now. Development league. I'm sick to death of it. I am. We practice more, we have a couple of breakouts and we tried three and, you know, nearly four break different scenarios and breaking the puck out. And I think the lads got a little bit confused on Saturday. I think sometimes you can overcomplicate things by having more different plays, and you know, we were, I think you've got to keep it quite basic, you know, if you've got wingers swapping with centre men and we're crossing through the middle or we're loading one side or anything like that, everyone has to be in that position at that key time, and there was a bit of running around and in the neutral zone and just breaking out over the blue line. But all these training sessions are geared for, more so, I mean, Hull's the next game we've got to take on, but it's more so geared for the Sunday against Widnes. You know, we can win the league at Widnes, which would be nice. Caffey made £1,150 last week. That's a record. The most he've ever made, £600.
That's much.
And last week he made £1,150, which is fantastic. His merchandise, I've actually, that picture in the corridor is unbelievable. You know, all that, what Pete's done in a week, really, a fortnight, which we could have been doing all season. He sold out of replica shirts at the weekend. Yeah, I don't know how many they had, but they were sold out in minutes. So, I mean, he's a good salesman, he's a good marketing guy, Pete. If we win the league, there's no reason we can't bring in more sponsorship here for next season. Big sponsorship. And then, you know, with him, super. You know, you need that extra 10, 15 grand on top of the team. It takes about 30 grand to run the team. So if we brought 50 grand in, and with the gate, you know, we're looking at, we could enhance our team now with more players.
Lads always have their own traditional spots. It's been like that for years and years. You kind of sort of, the older guys set their stall out. And that's it, that's the position that they'll be in. Goalies like to have homes up there, that's where they kind of live. But then when you get the newbies, sometimes the guys take a piss and they'll put them in their seats. Oh mate, you sit there? Yeah, no one sits there. And then the old boy comes in, oh no, it's all hell to break loose like. Oh, it's nasty. Kids get taped up, it's a bit of shaving, a bit of Ralgex on the, bit of shower gel in the boots, in the gloves. We do these things, it's an initiation, as we say.
How much is this going to take? Jesus, you've probably done 3 hours on it. It's just going to go off for a minute, isn't it?
3 hours ago, I'm not out of storage. That's all meant to be pressing the button. Delete. I reckon Law's going to get himself a dictaphone now.
Press record.
Yeah. Law's journal, day one.
Next season when I'm doing me level 3, mate, can you roll in me black book? doesn't stop. Turns us back on the puck.
Hey, that was once. That's the first time I've done it all year.
I've seen it plenty of times.
How is that banter? How does that banter sit with you?
Yeah, it's all right. I don't get involved too much, but I can hold my own when I have to, and that's what it's all about.
You're quite a quiet man in the dressing room. Do you think that balance of the craziness of some of the guys and the quietness of yourself and a couple of the others, do you think that's a happy medium and creates a good environment in the dressing room?
Everyone's different. I don't think it doesn't bother me that people loud in the dressing room, you know. I just like to sit here, I get changed quietly, and then, especially on game day, I don't really speak to many people. When I come in, take my sticks, have a chat, see what the lads have been doing over the weekends or whatever, if I haven't seen them since. And then once we start getting ready, I just kind of get in my own little place, get my kit on, and that's me pretty much done.
I got a good one from a Lithuania hockey tournament. That's how I chipped my tooth.
when I was younger, so thinking I was hard in the bar, asking him, it was me, Dangy, and another guy from Telford, asking him for the strongest drink in the bar, thinking I was the big I am, come out the toilet, trousers down my ankles, face flat on the floor, teeth out.
It was a quiet night then.
Yes, you know, it was a quiet night. Then they took me upstairs, shaved bits of my hair and took pictures with their balls on my head and all sorts of stuff, like, as you do.
Speaking of your hair, your hair seems to be quite
I had some changes,
item.
It?
Yeah! Oh, there's a camera! Come on! Get in there! I'm staying! I'm staying! You can see the penis! You can see the hair!
Rocking the braids at the moment, you know.
Where we've gone from?
Crazy afro.
Crazy, yeah. To
a bit uncontained.
And a bit of the tash going on.
A bit tonight. Of the mustache going on, but this is the last week. No, I'm cutting it off next week because it's just crazy. It's too much.
Have you got any superstitions?
Quite a few. New ones now here. When I leave at the change room, I have to tap the two metal things on the stick and then the door just before I go. And always touch the centre dot after the national anthem everywhere. Anyway.
I am a stat size, but I've got Al's Skate Shop to get me free stick, Pete Beakley. Best hockey shop in town. Okay. Got Al's Skate Shop for all your hockey needs.
We're on tight schedule. Go.
I don't know if I can say it to the camera, to be honest, but I never forget Benidorm and Matty Compton dressing up as Pam Randerson. That was a sight for sore eyes. But yeah, it's crack, like I say, crack a bunch of lads. You know, that many stories, you can't just pick one out.
In Sheffield, I was at a rec hockey tournament. Absolutely brilliant it was. We had beer in the water bottles and everything on the bench. But then I was quite drunk on the ice in one of the games and made a bad decision to turn down ice when I was facing backwards and somebody body checked me and I separated my shoulder on the ice. So I couldn't get up and, you know, well, I got up and tried to grab my stick. I couldn't hold my stick or anything and went back to the bench and just thought I'd be all right in a minute. So I grabbed another water bottle and carried on drinking the beer and everything. And then basically I was waiting there, thinking, oh, you know, it'll be all right in a minute. But got to the end of the game, I thought, I'm not all right, Ian. So I went and got changed in the changing room, got a first aider and stuff, and realised I'd separated my shoulder. So an ambulance was called, and I got taken in an ambulance where I was quite drunk, given gas and air and everything. And they were like, the two women in the ambulance were loving me. They were like, oh, we've never had a professional hockey player in here before. I was just thinking to myself the whole time, I'm not a professional, I'm a rec hockey player, but I'm going to milk it anyway. So I was like, yeah, professional me. And I enjoyed that. That was a good ride. And getting all that, you know, thinking I'm professional and everything.
Probably say when one of the guys gets on the ice with the skate guards on, goes flat on the face. I mean, there's been quite a few guys who've done that, especially for the start of the games, you know, when all the fans are watching, you're running out with the skate guards on. And of course, everyone in the team's seen him with the skate guards on, but they're not bothered to tell them.
Is it the banter that makes you continue to play?
Or oh, definitely. If the fun goes out of it, then it's one of them, isn't it? You know, as soon as the fun's out of it, you stop playing. You know, we're not getting paid. We all come here. We all got jobs. All got families. So as soon as that fun factor goes out of it, then I suppose it's time to move on. But while the banter's still here and all the lads are still having a laugh, then it's the most important thing, really.
Oh, I'm freezing.
So to be honest, one that stands out is Dave Clancy. When we first started playing with Manchester, we were doing a penalty shootout, and everyone knows he's a bit of a joke. And I think it was Rick Brabant going down on him, and he started doing forward rolls and jumping about, and still saved it. That's probably one that sticks out, because we had only just started playing. What was our first year professional, and he was doing that.
Yeah, so my folks used to go away a lot, and there was, I think Dave Clancy turned up at one of my house parties, so I wouldn't let him in unless he took the dog for a walk. So anyway, he took the dog for a walk, and by my mum and dad's house, there's a river, and the numpty was kicking stones into the water. And he kicked the stone into the water, the dog ran after it, and then when he got back to my house, I looked out the door and the dog was like like a drowned rat, really, shaking. I was like, what have you done to the dog? And he told me what had happened. And his paw was cut and he needed medical attention because he'd gone on something sharp. So he had to go for stitches. So, I don't know, poetic justice or something like that. It's my own fault, really, for trusting him with my dog. That won't happen again. I'm being Lowell's sort of apprentice and trying to do a bit of the goalies. That's my job this year.
How are the goalies getting on?
George has improved a lot, though. This season and last season, the speed's massively improved. Rebound control, he does really fine in his job to be honest. Really, really well. Lets himself down and find when we play teams which, you know, we should be blowing away. And he's only getting maybe 10 or 12 shots. I think those are the games that we struggled in this season. So it's only like one, two or three of them that's letting... He's not letting himself down, but he's letting himself get caught napping, if you know what I mean. He's not keeping that focus, whereas you look at Nottingham away, he gets his focus. He's got like 40, 50 shots and only letting two goals. It's tremendous goaltender from his point of view, from my point of view. We'll train this up like this. If Lowell can give me a few minutes, half an hour is what I tend to go for. Do positional play, rebound control, screens, recovery, hyperextension, overexertion, making saves, desperation, things that you would do in a game, things that try to switch the brain back on to making those saves to become sort of a natural thing to make that type of save rather than it being a desperation hitting his glove and then falling for a rebound. Instead, he's doing the desperation, knowing where it's going and keeping his own rebound or controlling it. Let me tell you, it ain't easy. It hurts. It hurts a lot. But it's for the love of the game. It takes a strange character to be a goalie. I think I fall under that. But from my point of view, it's like any sport, you want to be the goalie. It's either built into you or it's not. It's that hunger, that desire. Fearlessness, if you will. Stupidity, some people might call it. But that's what it takes. And from my point of view, I think we need to bring in more goalies, not just players. This club itself is so lacking goalies, and yet we're probably one in the Northwest that actually does goalie specific nights and trainings. Everyone's looking forward to Saturday's game now. Are you looking forward to Saturday's game? Are you looking forward to Saturday's game? Everyone should all be looking forward to Saturday's game. I'm not looking forward to the under 20s game, that I've got to coach first. Got players like can't play because they're banned or dropped out because they can't travel. Some guys want to just play home games and not Sunday games. But going back to goaltending,
yeah,
costs a fortune. That's why kids don't want to do it. And it's a shame we don't have something in place where someone would say, listen, for your club or the league, for your club, here's a goalie kit for every age group to try and entice kids to come in.
Like a starter kit.
Yeah, because it is the most expensive position, by far. Set of leg pads, even for a kid this big, 8, 7 years of age, talking £200-£400 for pads, £200 for a helmet, a pair of skates, rubbish about £200, catch a blocker, another £250, so you're talking well into the 1500s already, just for
free. Does the governing body not support the grassroots?
There are some government sponsorships out there. I mean, Deeside Junior Club have had one and got goalie starter kits from it, but only two sets, that's all they could afford. And they're in the club. I mean, you've just seen, well, I don't know if you know, but Richie Ryland's lads just started playing in goal now. And he's doing really, really well. He's showing a lot of potential. Seems to have that little, you know, niche and dive. What's that? I've got to stop it. It's not going past me, so... It's just the expense. These gloves cost you about £30.
How long do they last you?
You can get a good season out of gloves. Two seasons if you graft them. Charles, how long do you have them?
A season,
and they're still not calm, the holes. Not that he gets on the ice much, man, but they're still good condition. But, goalie gloves, £200.
Let's see, Gary!
Can't
protection blocker. It's just so expensive.
Here we have up and coming Palak with his trusty left top blocker sniper. Is he going to do something different? Well, I don't know what he actually did there, but my God, it made me feel sick. Alex Parry, last week's juice boy, will he be it again this week? Oh, it's a save by George. Onze, George, Onze, Onze. Side of interval, quick snap. No, through the legs. Oh, it's beautiful. Nice bit of skill by Sai. Shoots his players, shoots the crowd. Old timer with a bad back. Top corner glove. Good finish. Good finish for an old man. Hurry up and retire, son. Big Mike Jones. Mike Jones loves a classic top corner glove. And he's gone for his trusty backhand. Surprised. Surprised. Wipe the stick, son. Wipe the stick. Super, don't know what he's doing, he's full of tricks. That's probably one of the finest eeks you'll see, ladies and gentlemen. That is the import for the Dragons coming away with one of the best eeks you can have. I fear that Kenny is going to be juice boy. He's going to be juice boy. That's a... Hey, was the goalie even ready then? Was the goalie even ready? Matty Wainwright coming in, left-handed shot. That was no goal, that hit the post. Came out, it hit the post. Came out.
Wait, are we going to do a bit of commentating then?
Yeah, that came out.
No, it went in.
That did not go in.
Proven sniper around the league. Go for a toe drag. Judge Cox.
Solid watches save. It, P-roll by.
Great attempt.
My God, ladies and gentlemen, under-10s kids will be proud of that shot. Under-12s will be devastated. Turned him inside out there. He pulled his pants down, spanked him, put the puck in the net. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we're down to the last three contestants for Juice Boy. Snipper, Sakic, and Kenny. My money is still on Kenny. The aim now is to hit the crossbar or closest to the crossbar. Two pucks each. Here we go, Kenny to fire first. And he's a swing and a miss. Sakic's in there, oh he's up, swing and a miss for Snip. Can Kenny pull it back or Sakic's out of there? Sakic's out of there, Sakic's gone, it's out of Snipper and Kenny. Oh, I'm devastated, the coach has turned on his fellow coach partner. Give it to Snipper, Kenny's free, Kenny's out of it, can't believe it. Kenny, you couldn't even hit that water bottle over there.
Pre-game cake before the game, yeah.
Is that an important part of the process?
It is when it's free, yeah.
What type of cake is it?
Blueberry. Free blueberry cake. Lovely.
How are you feeling, Coxie? All right, yeah.
Just played another 20s game. Brief warm up. Get ahead of the game for the next one. Dave Clancy, how are you doing? Hockey night tonight!
It's all about the assist.
Yeah, I'm dying.
I'm still out.
Referee's missed all once,
bump. Stole one.
Are you
serious?
I stole one.
Are you ready for the game, boys, today?
Yup, like always. What? Is he a game?
It might be.
Training? Yes, can. Is it going to be? Training? Is it not training?
How are you feeling, love?
same as I feel before every game. I'm a nervous wreck.
The fact that they bought a very small squad tonight play into your head?
No, we prepare for every game the same. You know, it doesn't matter if you've got 25 or 5. It's the way we play hockey, not the way they play hockey. So, you know, we're going to prepare for every game the same. We're going to start with the same intensity. Team talk will be the same, and we have to get out there and do the same business on the ice. And, you know, by doing that all season, we're in a pattern now. Confidence is high, and hopefully, if we have got 8 players, we can burn them out early.
Are you happy that you've got this game tonight to prepare for tomorrow night's big game?
Yes and no. Yes, because it's a warm up for tomorrow, and no, because we've got to be careful of injuries and stupid penalties and anything like that. So, you know, if the lads can't play two games back to back on the weekend, then I haven't been doing my job right, getting them fit enough during the season. But should, you know, hopefully tonight it won't be too strenuous on them, and we'll get everyone playing tonight. We'll get everyone re-iced. You know, we'll give Kenny and Owen regular shifts who haven't been regular during the season. And I was going to address the line of kids tonight, but unfortunately they've left it too late to let us know. They only had 8 players, and a lot of the kids have gone. So shame about that.
No pressure. Easy team, knowing that they've got 8 as well. They're not going to be loads of energy. They're going to be tired in the first shift. And the way we've been training, no stopping us. And you'll see that tomorrow.
Are you looking forward to tomorrow?
Yeah. Oh, aye. It's going to be amazing. Exciting. The crowd's going to be big.
I think the fact that it's a local derby makes it even more sweeter.
Oh, yeah. All them lovers from Valentine's Day love the hockey more than the partners, and that's why they come and watch us.
Do you feel under pressure?
Not really.
Killers, can you cover this lad?
How are you feeling?
Great.
Really great.
Looking forward to the game?
Yeah, every time, you know. Still excited for games, like small kid, you know.
Yeah, another weekend, innit? Another one, getting the one out of the way, close to the league, and then tomorrow's the big one, innit?
You looking forward to that one?
Yeah, local derby, innit? The feisty game, hopefully.
Think that'll add to the tension?
Nah, I think the lads will still be relaxed, stick to the game plan, and, you know, I'm sure the result will come. Got a few good lads at witness, so, you know.
Are you friends with any of them?
I know Danny Bullock, I know a few of them, like, but. There's no mate on the ice, is there, in the local derby? Sure, if he's got his head done, I've got my head down, it's game on, innit? But no, he's a good lad. He used to play here, he did, Danny. And went over to witness, I think. So, yeah, he's a good lad. He come back from a knee injury as well, so. Yeah.
Do you think tonight's game's going to be useful in preparation for that tomorrow?
Depends how the lad's looking at it, you know, because, like, can't be too relaxed. I mean, last time with Hull, I think I wasn't playing, but I know the lads. They only got the winning goal in the last minute or so. So, you know, you can't take any team lightly in the league. You've got to 100% all the time. Mm-hmm. And then hopefully the results will come. Hopefully.
Tonight, we thought it was going to be a tough game, but we've just recently found out that, unfortunately, there's been a bit of a... Maybe it's a clash of players or games or something, but Hull haven't turned up with a very big squad tonight. I think they've turned up with 8 or 9 players, so I'm expecting the Dragons to come away with an easy victory tonight.
Nice ale in the cigar. Don't actually
Nice cigar.
We all in, boys? Hey, listen, I know we've only got 8 players, it means nothing. We're in our barn, and you know, I spoke to their manager before, and he basically said to me, you know, he had 10 this morning and 2 dropped out, and he's apologised that he's only brought 8, but he knew he'd have a crowd here and he didn't want to let us down. And he said to me, you know, you can have the 5-0 win now and we'll go home. And I said, no, no. And he said, well, tell your lads to take it easy. And I said, well, that's difficult.
No chance.
I said, because I've got lads who, you know, I've got 9 in the top 20 of the points thing. I've got 2 imports that are a few points behind Scott McKenzie. I said, so it's a little bit difficult to tell my lads to take it easy. I said, but at the end of the day, boys, this is a warm-up for tomorrow.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter how many they've got. We'll burn them out in a period. What you've got to remember, they brought 10 here, and they were leading us 2-1 with a few minutes to go. We cannot underestimate anyone. We can't go out there underestimating everyone. So, quick start, guys. Imperative.
They're still going to put up a fight, boys, even though there's 8 of them.
Yeah.
So let's work. Just work hard as we can from the start, yeah? Shut them out of the game. Hard we work to start, boys, the easier the rest of the game will be. They'll give up after 3-4 goals, and we'll get that quick if we work hard, boys.
Get off of the game, let's start thinking hockey.
I was thinking about sex.
Not anymore.
Brucey?
Yes.
Fuck's kicking the door.
What is Bruce? Wants to get out of here.
Go down! Let's go, guys. Let's move the fuck, Jake. Get up there quick.
There it is.
Use all the speed.
We're getting ice timing already. You've got a plan.
What are you still? I'm ready to go.
Yeah, f*** up.
I'm fucking dropping
the jump on, guys. Hey, come on. Go, Kelly.
I need on the stick.
Dragons back the other way. Adrian Palak deeks and shoots. Nice poke by the Hull defender there, just kept him off the puck. In the corner. Brought out to Bryn Roberts at the point. He's going to send it off the boards. Harry chooses to take it in, and Davis from the rebound. Palak was stationed right in the corner there, and the goaltender knew it. Yeah, but it. Davis finally beats Dean Bowater, puts one past him, and the Dragons have got their first point on the board here tonight. Deeside Dragons 1, Hull Jets 0.
We've got to work hard, guys. We've got to work hard for every game this season. From the off, we have to work hard. And we can't say, okay, we're playing with us tomorrow, I think I'll up my game tomorrow. Every single game, we've got to go into with the same mentality, working really hard. Most importantly, let's get our legs going. We're cruising. We're just, you know, the deer got the puck, the deer taking the puck back in the zone, and there's lads just like this. I'll have the puck. Let's get some speed. We can't take a slump into tomorrow night's game. We can't take slow on our feet in tomorrow night's game. We've got to go out there now. I just want to see effort. I just want to see speed. That's all I want to see. I don't want to see fellas not skating. Let's just take it all back to basics, right back into our zone, move the puck up quickly, and we'll batter these. We will batter them. But at the moment, we're not skating hard enough. They've got 8 players in there. You know what? It's a little bit embarrassing at times, because they've got lads on for 3 or 4 minute shifts. We've rolled 3 lines through the same kid, and he's still skating faster than us.
Boys, because it's a 4-on-4 in their zone, you've got more room. That's why I was shouting cycle, lol, shouting cycle. Get a little bit of a cycle going on. You can stretch off into that high slot area. You'll get your passes. Dicko had 2 or 3 passes, air wide open. Because they're getting, because there's only 4 in there, there's no way they can close down all those pockets.
It's got a short bench. Why the hell are we showing up so much respect and not taking a body tonight?
Yeah.
The more you smash them, the more tired they're going to get.
the more mistakes you're going to make, because you're just going to panic as soon as you get the puck and you try and throw it away. It's our barn boys, look at the size of the crowd that's turned up tonight.
Super takes a shot, and that just trickles in behind the netminder. A bounce there that just pays off for Philip Super as the Deeside Dragons are on the board in the opening 2 minutes. As Hull now desperately need to get back in this game, a beach is clear, out front shot, and it's in, it's a goal for the Hull Jets.
What a goal.
Courtesy of Kieran Beach. Down the other way is Beach again, he's out front, shot, and it's in! It's a goal for Kieran Beach! Two goals in the space of a few minutes, and Hull are right back in this game.
And it's like I said, Dave, short bench or not, do not write the team off.
Deeks gets clear, a shot! What a goal!
And as we said that, he goes and does what he always does.
Dixon stops it on the boards. But now Hull the other way, 2-on-1, Beach. Shot, and it's a goal! Kieran Beach has a hat-trick on the night. As the Hull tie this game up in the 16th minute of the second period, 3-3.
This is down to again like last weekend. This period now is about who wants it the most. There's a league title on the line here, boys, and we're playing against eight men. So that's got nothing to do with it. This is all about effort and doing the little things right now, boys, and going hard for 20 minutes and getting this job done before we go to Widnes tomorrow night and seal the deal. This is all about who wants it the most. There's no way I'm getting beat by these tonight. Not a chance. So everyone in this room, dig deep and give whatever you've got, whether we're going against 8 men or 18 men, and we get the job done, boys, because we're not coming in here drawing or losing, end of. Think about what we've got to do here, boys.
Priority is, in their zone now, we've got to cut that gap out between them flipping the puck to that guy and creating the one-on-one. And the only way we can do that is the minute we lose the puck in their zone, we'll have Philip or Adrian pushing the puck carrier, and the other three get right back, straight away, right back, and think about cutting out any pass in the neutral zone.
Lovell at centre ice. Parry under pressure from Forster. As you see, Mark Lovell on the forward line there, stationed in front of the net. Position we've been so used to him playing this season. He was put on the defence at the start of this game.
Oh, there it is.
But it's paid off putting him on that forward line. There's the go-ahead goal for the Dragons.
It's been coming, been slowly passing around, waiting for that opportunity, and Lovell puts it in.
Hull Jets didn't manage to capitalise on the power play. Dragons are now back to full strength. Palak turns it round. Parsons shoots and it's a goal! Deeside Dragons go up 2! With 10 minutes remaining in the third period. Dixon hustles back, manages to keep the puck away from Forster, and it's turned round. Super shot and a goal! Super from Dixon! And it beats the netminder out, and with just over 8 minutes remaining in this game, the Dragons have extended their lead to 3.
Lesser players maybe.
Palak shot, and Mark Lovell gets another one, courtesy of Pollack. It's 7-3 and the Dragons, proving their dominance late in the game. So a correction to that last goal, it was Alex Parry scored that from Lovell. And as I turn away to check my notes, the Dragons go up another goal. It's 8-3. Dragons bring it into the whole zone as we...
Oh, it's in.
It's another goal for Deeside. They extend the lead. Was that Adrian Pollack?
I don't think Hull got a touch on that.
Dragons looking to make it 10 in the final minute. Insult to injury as Davis gets it in. Shot. The rebound is out. Pollack gets it in. It's another goal, and the goaltender completely frustrated now. A comfortable victory for the Dragons as Beach plays it in for the last time for Hull. They've had an outstanding game. Score does not reflect how well the Hull Jets have played, I must say.
Well, Dave, my man of the match definitely for Hull. Although he had a good game in net, Bowater, I've got to give it to Beach, because without his attacking, wouldn't have given them the points that kept them in this in the first two periods.
Kieran Beach, a hat-trick for him. He's the only goal scorer for Hull. Had an outstanding game. And this now puts the Deeside Dragons within 2 points of winning the league title.
They can almost taste it, Dave. They can almost taste it.
Tomorrow we're going to start the game with the team we finished with tonight, and that doesn't mean the fourth line. We're going to rotate Paul and Si, Snipper and Dicko and Alex and Larry around the two imports to start the game tomorrow. Kenny Williams is going to play defence with Bryn, and Stevie Fellows is going to play defence with Matty. That's how I'm going to start the game tomorrow, boys. But with everyone dressing, I want everyone to dress. We can win the league tomorrow, but we've got to try and win the league. Okay, I've got nothing else to say. Great day, Fairies. Stop doing it to me. And let's put the music on and celebrate. Let's have a beer. Let's play.
Let's
make another
sack.
Come on. Let's play
Oliver. Let's
play.
The following night, a 7-7 draw at local rivals Widnes Wild is enough to crown the Deeside Dragons as champions. But Widnes are scheduled to meet the Dragons at home on the day of the championship ceremony, and Widnes are also expected to make a strong showing versus the Dragons at the playoffs in Sheffield. This local rivalry has only just begun. Next time on Dragons Fire.
Bye bye,
Stevie. That's it. Demons are calling.
We're a bell for the league champions.
Oh, and here we go.
Kemp is completely incensed. Are they leaving? Witness, out of protest for the call from the referee, are leaving this game tonight.
It's all over.